Ahoy, welcome back to more BioShock Infinite. Here in the Hall of Heroes. Shut up. Okay. Just checking where the next infusion is, because I didn't actually look. Okay. Nothing. Can't get the shotgun upgrade. Room. Sorry, what? Hold on. I'm looking at Soldier's Field, not Hall of Heroes. And back here, infusion. Some more shield.
Just give us the shock jockey.
If you want the vigor, you will give my men the soldier's death. They wait for you in need, baby.
And then another fucking bronco, if you didn't pick it up earlier. Now for Wounded Knee in Peking.
I'll try to keep you stocked with both bandages and everything. The right materials aren't always at hand.
I don't remember which one's the easiest. I think it's the Boxer Rebellion that's slightly easier. I'm taking the carbine damage boost, because I need more damage. And there are worse things to spend money on. Gear piece, throttle control, I think this one's guaranteed. Which that then opens up or unlocks a guy out here to spawn.
Fire!
Where did he go? There he is.
You see, young miss. You see the man that Comstock wishes he was. A real soldier.
I don't want to do this, Slate. Just give me what I need.
I will. After you do the same for me. Come and look for me amongst the ghost dancers.
Who are the ghost dancers?
Wounded knee. He means us to head to the other display.
Comstock's tin soldiers coming to silence us. But we are the true patriots. The history that does not fit in their books.
So now off to do... what is it? Wounded Knee. Another gear piece, winter shield, which not needed. A zealot does spawn in here. Where is he? I didn't set the timer again because I'm an idiot. So I need 51 minutes. Okay.
A choice is better than
moving on.
No matter what the outcome.
Yeah. I've got what you need. If you woke up one day and realized you didn't like what you chose.
You've seen what Comstock has done to my history. Now see how he's rewritten his own.
Go this way, because I think that's... Nope, it's not here. It's somewhere else. And then here's...
The prophet lay in the womb of Our Lady, but for a single week. Comstock had a child. My books never mention anything about a child.
That's quite an admission. Can't imagine that was by accident.
child took ill, and Our Lady prayed for the prophet's heir day and night.
Oh, I have to move on, don't I? I completely forgot that this wasn't the lockpick one. Yeah, that's sort of the big reveal for Elizabeth for the first half of the game. And Voxphone, which I think that Voxphone talks about how she was unaware of the child. Just checking with the next okay.
I can get through these bars, but you're too broad. Let me scout ahead, see if there's some way to move forward. Something I can bring into this world.
It's a freight hook. Well, that's convenient.
As I said, it's a form of wish fulfillment.
Elizabeth!
You bet.
So yeah, now I have access to the tears.
I don't know where that came from. Whenever I get anxious, tears have a way of appearing. Booker, do you see those tears? We can use them against Slate's men. That tear will get us access to higher ground. And that one will give us a turret.
And some cover.
Well, I don't want to do that, so do that.
Not sure I understand this, but I'm not complaining.
I missed with the one I was aiming at. Okay, now he's about to shoot himself. And that's everything. That one.
That's enough, Slate. We just need the Vigor to get out of Columbia. We're taking it one way or another. Slate!
There's a hack to vending machine there. Oh, it's just discounted. Wait. It's a dollar bill. But it gives the clip increase. For the pistol, why? Alright. Possession for less, which isn't really needed.
More money. Here.
That'll do.
Okay.
To the sky.
I'm about to have a mini boss fight with that guy there.
Too rare is the man who takes the stand in you and God and sweetest fatherland. Was here the place where we revere the heroes of our city.
Wires and gears to replace heads and hearts.
Okay. I just want to point out, I've never actually done that before, and that was just something I thought, I might try this. Surprise, it's all smashed.
The whole place is ransacked. No shot to get here.
Slate must have taken them. Look.
Locked. Elizabeth?
Really? That little old lock. All done.
Now we go back this way. Fairly sure these don't get anything new yet. This one first.
We don't need to do this.
Right.
Here you go, boys. A soldier's death awaits.
Nope, apparently not. Okay, the first wave. Yep, he's opening up this door. Then back here, in this infusion.
Just for the doctor.
Okay.
For the glory of Columbia.
Okay, from the heel. Is that everything? Nope, I hear another one.
Show me what you're made of. Elizabeth.
Done.
Yeah, that was all of them. So, this I think leads to essentially nothing. Yeah, there's nothing back here. Except a couple of bins. I can't remember if there's anything up here at all. I don't think there is. Okay, so I know where the next one is. Through here. Need more salt. I guess the good thing about this game as opposed to the original two, you can see how many like shots of your vigors you have left. Unlike in the sequel where you don't get to see that. Let's turn the game down a little, because it's extremely loud for me. There we go. And then right here, get Shock Jockey.
You're not done here, soldier! Eat everything that's on your plate! Finish it!
I'm gonna spare him. I've spared him for a specific reason that will come up later. And now I have the best vigor in the entire game. Basically, once you get the chain lightning thing for this, it's by far the best. Yeah, so basically these are the two vigors I'm going to be predominantly using, just because they're both really good. Oops.
Need money?
Nice.
Okay, I'm almost at 3,000. All right. Now.
Do it.
Have Shock Jockey equipped. Still someone alive. They're down there, okay. And they're dead. So now I'm going to show off some of the cool things with Shock Jockey, because there's actually a few things which aren't mandatory to do. Like, they don't even give you that much. So you shock this, remember the maintenance path, you go up here, and then up here, there might be a gear bit up here. I think there's a bunch of lockpicks. Yep, there's gear. Gearhead become harder to detect. Affects automated turrets, zeppelins, and motorized patriots. I've never actually gotten that one before. So yeah, gear piece, a lockpick. I got a bunch of salts from that crate, which isn't guaranteed. Then over here, I believe, yep, sniper rifle. Some money, not a whole lot else. Yeah, there's a gear piece up here. Now, head to the line, and jump on. For some reason, I didn't want to use Bronco. And here's my new best friend, the Motorized Patriot. Just gonna check if there's... I know there's a lockpick and a few health items. Wanna see if there's any salts or anything. You can pick up an RPG, which... At this point, if you don't have an RPG, you're probably not gonna be... You're not gonna pick up that one. So just jump onto there, jump down to here, orange and a pineapple. Now I believe a bunch more enemies are back here. Oh, he's dead. So yeah, here's a little tip for 1999 difficulty. I'll let her speak first.
To attend to that distinction, Booker. And there's a moment when we're not being shot at. If you're interested, I spotted some supplies over there.
Which we've already been through there, so it's not important. Here's a little tip for 1999. So I shot the fireman off the edge accidentally. That is actually a very good strategy for 1999 difficulty. If like you're having difficulty dealing with them. Like same thing with zealots. Because they can both be launched off the edge using Bucking Bronco and any weapon with either like multiple pellets, such as the shotgun, or a higher fire rate. So anything except for like the sniper, the hand cannon. I know the RPG can't. Potentially there are other weapons I can't, but I can't think of them. And then here is how you deal with Patriots. This is on hard difficulty, but like I don't think the difference between hard and 1999 is actually that much. So, now we have a few other little things to do. First things first, come here, lift the gate. Then, if you look over there, the Nahida replica is gone. There's a sort of shock jockey there, which you have to pick up shock jockey so that one doesn't make a difference. Zap this. This opens. Some shotgun shells. And another gear piece. Nitro vest. Not very useful because I'm not using explosive weapons. It's also a sniper rifle. And that's everything in this room. I can't remember, is there a cash register in here that you can actually take from? Doesn't look like it. So you go back out here. Then onto the skyhook line. land here. Zap this. Get some salts. Lockpick, there's cigarettes if you have taken the health infusions. No lockpick. And another gear piece. Hillrunner's hat. So this is the... So if you were to speedrun this game... So in the previous episode I mentioned that there was a gear that you farm. This is what you are looking for from that gear piece. You farm until you get the Hillrunner's hat. You then get the earliest rocket launcher. Which I'm not sure which one they use. I think they use the one that you can get immediately after jumping off the skyline going to the Hall of Heroes. You then shoot the ground with this and it boosts your movement speed. And you just keep doing that. And then there's a Vox phone explaining what happened here. Now we go over here. Power up the gondola. Pull the lever. Then... I need that motorized Patriot. I can't. Welcome to the part of this where I'm going to be using the skylines to my advantage. Where did he just go? There another enemy that you can actually use the strategy of forcing them to deal with gravity. Where are you? I can hear him. Oh, they're up there. Okay. Well, one is, where's this other one? No, that's the gun automation. Or automaton or whatever he is. How did you get up there? Okay, there's the gondola. Another one. Then there's another Patriot. And hairpin lock. Step inside, pick up another lockpick and some money. And pool level.
When you were unconscious on the beach, you kept repeating a woman's name. Anna.
I don't want to talk about that.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have cried. Where are you from, Mr.
New York.
What did you do there?
Business much like this.
Thing you came along and you did.
How do you think I ended up here? I gambled, and now I owe money to men you don't want to be in debt to. I come.
Just double checking everything on OBS is working still.
Me busting you out. What do you think that was? Charity?
Who sent you?
Somebody who was willing to take my marker in exchange for you.
Okay. Kind of wish this conversation went for slightly longer, just so that something actually happened on this. So let's see, so that's not the, where's the statue? No, seriously, where's the statue? Also, why are there like three Ferris wheels? Because there's one over there. There's one there. There's one there. Oh. That's right. Completely forgot about this bit. I always forget about this room. Still no new upgrade. I just need the shotgun upgrades. And then nothing worth taking at the moment from here. I will potentially be grabbing this later to do, to try out something that I learned about through a Steam guide. But I'll get to that in a moment.
Shepherd.
And you the lamb.
Let's not call each other that.
Since me.
How do you figure they'd know you'd be coming?
Either they've got a prophet on their side.
Har har.
Or them that hired me also wrote the signs.
Why?
Got me.
So, on here, grab the massive pile of money and an infusion to boost shield.
Found some money.
So, I should explain. The reason why I take shield over health, shield replenishes itself. Health does not. So I choose to boost the thing that requires the least amount of maintenance. Basically, like, if you don't get hit for a certain period of time, you've got shield. You don't need to worry about that. If you get hit with a ton of health and no shield, well, you've then got to find some way of healing. So I choose to take shield over healing, but basically it's personal preference with that. I do recommend, though, taking salts first, just because salts are way more important in the long term. So yeah, use the console. Leave area.
You alright?
I want to see Paris. I want to see everything.
It's up to you now. There's no one.
Wait, what is that? 40 North by 74 West. That's not Paris, that's New York.
How did you know that?
One thing I had in that tower was time, Mr. DeWitt. Time to study things like geography.
I owed money. A fellow
he already explained all this.
Away my debt in exchange for you. Come on. Come on. Everything's gonna be okay. Will you just turn around and talk to me and we can...
I'd like to point out, he's been shot, set on fire, attacked with a sword, but a small girl with a wrench is what knocks him down. And now we make the Vox. And right there is one of the hardest enemies in the game. Okay. Now off to Finkton.
The most common complaint I hear from the working men is that they are unhappy with their lives. What? Sure.
They fire the man?
Flying squad came and took him. You ain't gonna see him around no more.
The Veni Vidi Vigor, Bronco Aid. Purchase that. Because Bucking Bronco is one of the very important vigors of the playthrough. The only one that is arguably more important is Shock Jockey. Oops. Word of advice, avoid alcohol in this game because it drains your salt, which is more important than anything. So you got money at your feet. Can I? Just please. There we go, got it. Then... Okay. Where there? Okay, just ignore him. He can't kill me from there. They can wait a moment. Up ammo now. Where did you come from? Gear piece. Fitness hurdle. When revived, recover at full health. What am I currently wearing? I think I'm wearing melee kills. I will equip that. Okay, there's nothing else here. So moving on. We've now got a chase sequence. More carbine ammo. And
get out of here, sniper. You wanna know what we do to pretty little stowaways?
There's Elizabeth.
Maybe you don't.
Hey! Just stop
get
for
away
a minute!
From me. Stay away.
I don't think there's anything back here.
I just want to talk to you!
I said stay away!
Elizabeth!
Get away from me!
Just hold up for a minute!
Stay away.
I'm not angry with you! Hey, watch out! Move it! Move!
Then train. Yep, just seeing where the next one is. Okay, yeah, so I know what that one is as well. Now to save Elizabeth, but first. Another RPG. Sniper rifle. The explosives guy. There's a guy wearing a lion mask here, and I don't know where he is, which is not a good sign. Okay, I hear him. You die. You die. Just make sure my shotgun's loaded. My shotgun is loaded and my carbine. There's one more guy up there. I do need to go downstairs, so I'll do that quickly. Wait, what was boost? Increased damage. Okay, so I might need that later. So now I need to go down. Elizabeth was up there in that room, but I need to be down here. Because in... here. Another infusion. Then up here, over here. Wouldn't let me jump off for some reason. And it's a handyman. Elizabeth saved the day.
Hey, I'm slipping.
Do not attempt to follow me, Mr. DeWitt.
Elizabeth, I've made an arrangement to get our airship back.
You can get us out of here.
Yes, I just need to supply enough weapons to arm an entire uprising.
And where will we get these weapons? From one of our many friends and allies?
A gunsmith in Finkton. Should be a walk in the park. What do you say, partners?
You're a liar, Mr. DeWitt. And a thug. You're also my only means of reaching Paris.
Okay. There you go. Here, get Elizabeth picking that. And in here, silver bar and another gear piece. The current hat. I'll actually use that because that's not bad. Shotgun, finally, I can get the damage boost on the shotgun. So, purchase that. Reload increase. And that's everything I can currently get for the shotgun. Oh, it's a vending machine. I thought it was a Veni Vidi Vigo. Okay, so I'm going to end the episode here. We are now at Finkton, which is one of the longest areas in the game, I think it's safe to say. So this entire area could take us 2 episodes, 3 episodes potentially. It would definitely at least bare minimum take an episode and a half. Because it's a very long area involving, I think, actually 3 different areas. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you've enjoyed. Fuck off, cunt.